Channels in Google Analytics are groupings of traffic based on specific rules. For example, traffic that comes to your site via a social media site would be considered to be in the organic social channel. Unless you say it's from an ad, then it would end up in the paid social channel. Universal Analytics also had channels, but there were limits. For example, we didn't have a paid social channel built in, so we had to do some extra work to separate out that traffic from organic social traffic, which were just called social. In GA4, we not only have this new paid social channel, but we also have a number of other new channels. In this video, I'll show you which channels are new and how to make sure your website traffic will show up in the correct channel in GA4. First, let's talk about GA4's default channel groupings. These are the default traffic sorting rules that come with GA4, and you can see a list of those in our website. Some of the channels are brand new to GA4, and those are audio, which can be used for podcasts, radio ads, audio-only content. We really like using this for tracking URLs. I'll get to that towards the end of the video. Cross-network, so this is visitors from ads from different networks, such as an ad that's allowed to be on both display and search networks. Mobile push notifications, SMS, pretty clear what that is. And lastly, there's now paid and organic channels for shopping, social media, and video, which is pretty exciting. You may already be seeing traffic show up in these new channels in GA4, but if you aren't seeing them in your acquisition reports, definitely start using them if it makes sense for you. We particularly find the audio and paid social channels the most useful, as those were channels that we would set up as custom channels in Universal Analytics. Now, of course, we had custom channels in Universal Analytics, but what about in GA4? There are indeed custom channels in GA4 that you can set up. What's great about custom channel groups is you can create additional rules for traffic that make sense for your unique situation. So in this case, let's say we have a client who uses links in PDFs a lot, and they want to make sure that those are tracked in their own separate PDF channel. So let's set that up. First off, I'm in the admin screen of GA4, and if you don't know how to get to this screen, you click the cog at the bottom left-hand corner, and then you're going to open up this data settings section here, and then you're going to click on channel groups. Now there's the default channel group, but if I click on this, you can see that I cannot modify this. I have to create my own new channel group. So we'll click on create new channel group, and then we're going to enter in the group name and the description. So in this case, we'll just name it with PDFs. Then we're going to click add new channel to add the channel that we need to add. So in this case, the channel name will be PDFs, and then we're going to click add condition group, and then we're going to decide on the condition. In this case, we're going to decide that the medium needs to equal PDF exactly. We're going to click apply, and then anything that comes in with UTM that has a medium of PDF will now be slotted into this PDF's channel. We'll click save channel, then we'll click save group, and now you can see we've got the second PDF channel here. Now to actually see these channels in your reports, we're going to go back into reports and then go into acquisition and traffic acquisition. And then you can see if you open this up, now you can see we've got the with PDFs channel we created. Now, how does traffic end up in these channels? GA4 uses information it receives when someone visits your website to pick what channel that traffic belongs to, and that information can be received via refer information, ad network information, or UTM parameters. Refer information means what page was this person on before they got to this page. For example, if you clicked a link on a Google search to get to this video, your refer would be google.com. So then YouTube's GA4 would know that you came to this website from a Google search and that it wasn't a paid result unless there's ad network information present. How can you tell if an ad network was used? Have you ever noticed that when you click a Google ad, you see a whole bunch of random characters at the end of the URL that looks like this? That GCLID part tells GA4 that this visit was via an ad, and encoded in that URL are details on exactly how that ad was generated. Was it a display ad? Was it on Google search? And so on. This information then tells GA4 how to categorize this visit in their various ad-related channel categories. Other ad networks do something similar. So if you click an ad on Facebook, you'll see FB, CLID in the URL, and GA4 knows what networks to watch out for and how to categorize that resulting traffic. Now, if GA4 doesn't have these hints, doesn't have a refer, doesn't have ad network details, this is when UTM parameters come in and can help you tell GA4 where that traffic is coming from. You've probably seen UTM parameters in use in the past. A URL with UTM parameters would look something like this. That example link was in the description of one of our YouTube videos, and we want to know how many people clicked that specific link, so we added UTM parameters. What do those parameters mean? Let's go through them. UTM source is where the traffic came from. In this case, it was YouTube. UTM medium is the category the traffic falls into. In this case, it would be social media. UTM campaign tells us if that was associated with a campaign. You can use this parameter to group all the traffic from a campaign together. In this case, our campaign is the video ID, that random number of letters that shows up in the URL, because we want to know what YouTube video it came from. UTM term is usually used for a keyword. We didn't use that parameter. Didn't make sense for this link. And UTM content can be used to differentiate ads or placements. In our case, we want to know this link was in the description area of our YouTube video, so we called it description. Now, you don't need to use all of these. You only need to use the UTM source and medium at a minimum. The others are totally optional. There's also some new UTM parameters in GA4. There's UTM source platform, which is the name of the platform that sent the traffic, such as Google Ads, usually used for ads traffic. And there's UTM creative format and UTM marketing tactic. You can't currently see these in GA4, but you can still send them to GA4. Also, we recommend following these best practices when creating your UTM parameters. First, always use lowercase letters. GA4 is case sensitive, so if you use Facebook title case and Facebook all lowercase in a UTM source parameter, that traffic will not be grouped together. Always lowercase is safest. Second, you can replace spaces with a plus symbol. The plus symbol is turned into a space in GA4. And third, be consistent. We have a free campaign tagging tool on our website that you can copy for your own use, and make sure that everyone on your team is on the same page about what UTM parameters to use in your traffic tracking. Now, even with all this helpful tracking information, you can still end up with lots of traffic showing up in your direct channel in GA4. What is direct traffic? Many people think of direct traffic as bookmarks or people typing in a URL directly, and that can absolutely show up as direct traffic. But there's many other sources of direct traffic as well. For example, a visitor coming back to a tab they've had open for many months, visits from some social media sites or apps. Some will let GA4 know where the visitor came from, others, such as Mastodon, strip away any referrer information, or a link click or a tap from a chat message, such as in Slack or iMessage. Essentially, direct traffic is any traffic that arrives at your website without any referrer information at all. But if your link has UTM parameters, it doesn't matter what the referrer information is or even if it's there, GA4 will use the UTM parameters first. So that means that you can change how that information be categorized in GA4. UTM parameters can help you track traffic that would otherwise be untrackable. We also often use UTM parameters in tracking URLs. And by tracking URLs, that's a website address visited, and then it redirects you to a different URL with UTM parameters appended. For example, if you go to kpplaybook.com/podcast example, you'll be redirected to this other URL with these UTM tags added on. This traffic would end up in the audio channel with the UTM medium set to audio. Then we use the source parameter to indicate what podcast we were on, and then the campaign to indicate if it was this specific tracking URL that we mentioned. When you use a tracking URL, you can mention that you're on a podcast. So you can say, for more information, visit yoursite.com/podcast name. And then you would know how many people actually went to that page via the podcast episode, instead of saying just the name of your site and hoping you can figure out how people found you or what podcast appearance was the most effective. And finally, one more channel you probably will see in GA4, the unassigned channel. Unassigned traffic will show up in your channel groupings when GA4 really doesn't know where this traffic should go because the UTM parameters in the URL doesn't match any of the GA4 channel rules. The traffic isn't direct because there's parameters, it came from somewhere, but the parameters don't make any sense, so it goes to unassigned. Unfortunately, the unassigned channel is often where good traffic can disappear in a sea of unrelated sources and mediums. For more information about unassigned traffic and why you want to avoid it, check out our GA4 audit dashboard. And there you have it. Everything you need to know about the new channel groups in GA4 and how to use them. Do you still have more questions? Check out our other videos to get more answers and leave a comment letting us know what topics you want us to cover in future videos. Thanks so much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe.